Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Games Re-Up. Today we are looking at Sensible Soccer on the Master System. Made by Sony ImageSoft in 19... what was it? 1992, of course it was. How could I forget that? Okay, let's have a look through the menus a sec. Let's have a look. So you've got your game length, you've got your music, menu music on and off. Pad buttons, 2 or 1. One button would be a terrible game of football. Team class or difficulties. Let's have a look. I think we will... we're not going to play as pro. Let's come out of that. Let's play friendly. No? You've got your pitch types, number of teams, you've got your different cups. Look at that. UEFA Cup. Jesus. Okay, let's do some team selection, shall we? What have we got here? Dortmund. Yes, Dortmund. Who should I play as? Madrid? Yes, play as Madrid. Let's do that. Because we all know Madrid are awesome. But then it's over Dortmund. Here you go, you can play in your 5-4-1s, your 4-4-2s, up to you which way you play your formation. I think we're going to go with the 4-4-2. Look at that. There's even some real decent customization for the day. Just change the colour of your shirt. Even though it's really pixelated, you can actually make it out when you're actually playing. But yeah, for back then, it was a pretty decent. Game on, let's do this. Now, you know, I'm not very good at football games in the first place. I will be the first to tell you that. But, you know, there's no harm in trying. Let's kick the ball, we're off. Well, that wasn't a good start, I'm not going to lie. It is hard to get used to the buttons, I'm not going to lie. Even though it is a two-button control, it's really hard to know which direction you're actually shooting in. But with a bit of practice and a couple of games, you'll be fine. And we're going to see a goal here already from the opposing team. Got a penalty already. Brilliant. Losing already. 1-0. Okay, so 6 minutes in. Let's get the ball. Brilliant, straight out again. As you can tell, I don't play a lot of football games. When I do, I'm terrible at them. But I suppose this is a fun game, really. It's got a nice arcadey feel to it. Once you have played it a couple of times, you'll be absolutely fine. With a couple of mates, this is brilliant. A couple of beers. Goal kick. Here we go. Yep, brilliant. I can't get the ball once. There we go. I'm on the run. No, I'm not. Yellow card. You fouled me. Brilliant. 2-0 to them. Here we go. On the run, on the run. Oh, Got the ball. Cut. This is what I was saying. It's not that easy. In fact, it almost feels like you don't really have control of the ball. You're kind of just influencing it slightly. It's kind of how it feels to me. What really would help is if I just stop fouling people. One thing I've got to say about this game is the graphics are simple, but it works. Do you know what I mean? For the Master System, it's quite a pretty game, colourful game. The animations are fine. You can see them sliding across, you can see their little legs running. You can make out the people. But yeah, no, it's a good looking game for its age. Half time. There's not much in the way of sounds on this game. I mean, you've got the crowd noise. You even have a little bit of chanting, which is pretty decent for the time. This little 8-bit system. Obviously you've got the whistle, very simple little whistle, but it works, you know exactly what it means. These sort of games you just don't get anymore. Simple football games. Arcadey type football games. FIFA's now all about the realism. There's no sort of arcadey fun to it. Apart from when you're playing 2-button, I suppose. But, yeah, no, it's just, you could literally muck around on this game and just play random games with your mates. You don't need to take it seriously. It's just fun. Overall, I'd say well worth it. This game, I only bought it for $1.99 from a second-hand game store. That's a bargain, $1.99. If you can pick it up, do it. Get a few mates around, get a couple of beers, have a great game of sensible soccer. It's really, really worth it. Like I said, hunt it down, you'll find it really, really easily, and really cheaply. Or, it's on Xbox Live as well, so you can get it on there pretty cheaply as well, for under about 3-4 quid. Slightly updated, but still the same sort of mechanics. Anyway, that just about wraps it up. My name's Alex from Games Re-Up, and my next review is going to be incoming on the Dreamcast, but that'll be coming shortly. Thanks again, click subscribe, and see you soon.